Okay, so I'm in an undisclosed location, but it's not the whole, it's I'm in a hotel, motel, but it's not the Holiday Inn. Let me see. This Wi-Fi connection here is kind of slow, so I have to wait for the songs to load. See if it works. I wrote a few words down. First, I'll say Om Namah Shivaya. Kling Krishnaya Govindaya Gopi Jana Vallabhaya Swaha. Hey Krishna Karuna Sindho. Dinabando Jagatpate, Gopesha Gopika Kanta, Radha Kanta Namostute. Getting lost in the complexities of life. This is what we do, right? We get lost in the complexities of life. All of us. So, getting lost in the complexities of life, we lose sight of the essential simplicity of it all. Either we blindly place our faith in gods whom we do not actually know due to the promptings, warnings, and even threats from pompous and mentally corrupt priests and all religious elders, or we opt instead to live a life merely dedicated to the satisfaction of our all too animalistic senses, while turning our backs on anything that is not immediately perceivable, as if a limited view on existence could ever be the last word on anything. So, in this wise, we have two extremes, don't we? We have these types of people that, like atheists, who feel that anything that is not immediately perceivable or pragmatically realized, tangibly felt, cannot possibly exist. Meanwhile, they go on and on talking about some external reality, which is the only reality that makes sense to them, scoffing at all things subtle. Meanwhile, these very types entertain, not only entertain, but take their thoughts seriously. Huh? They take their lives seriously. And if thoughts are merely chemical processes, then why do they even continue living? This is what I'm asking. And then you have those who have a very childish perception of spirit, of what gods are. And so both schools of thought pain me. I'm reading this very interesting book. I'm loving it. The Crucifixion of Truth by Tony Bushby. A lot of things in there that he's bringing to the fore I think are necessary to find out about. But all the quotes in the world, all the bibliographical proofs in the world, it seems like we have to have proofs all the time in order for something to be taken seriously. We forget about the simplicity. You know, I always use these words like simplicity, infinity, eternity, endlessness. I have to stop this because it's going to stop at some point, so I have to let it load. We always, you know, I always use these terms because, see, we spend our lives overwhelmed by what surrounds us. And what surrounds us is nothing but, you know, an expansive field of thought, the likes of which there is no known end. The likes of which, likewise, there is no perceivable beginning. So, consciousness. Consciousness is real. To assume that only we, in this day and age, have the key to unlock this consciousness based on some corny idea of evolution, imagining that the past, that there is only a certain amount of, you know, that people in the past could never be as advanced as we are today, it's just, to me, that's nonsense. What is consciousness? Consciousness is cognition. Cognition is awareness. Awareness of what? It doesn't stop. There's no end to what any one of us can be aware of and are aware of. So, we play with thoughts. We all do. We focus on objects, objectives. There's nothing wrong with that. It's natural. Starry, starry night. But see, paint your palette blue and gray. There is a common thread in all of this. We are all co-creators. We get overwhelmed by the creations of the past that face us in the now, in the present moment. And all of us, we get overwhelmed and we forget. What are the most important things to focus on? Far be it from me to lay any sort of dogmatic trip, but me focusing on certain thoughts, on certain beings. You know, it's not stupidity. There are many things I cannot prove. That doesn't mean that they aren't real. I was going to prepare this whole thing and write this, but so much. So much constantly going through my head. Morning fields of amber gray. I never really know withered faces how I will end up. I have no idea. I know that I need a certain amount of steady, and yes, I'll say it. I see what's out there. There's a lot of garbage out there. So I am qualified to teach, knowing fully well that a teacher is also a student. That doesn't mean that you cannot learn from a teacher. And there are so many different subjects to learn from and to teach. I'm not against, let me call it, the concept of Christ. I'll even say this, I'm not against the concept of Krishna, of Shiva. Because to me, what matters is what one is doing in one's life with these concepts. And one's very life is not an illusion. The delusions surrounding one's life are illusions. But one's very soul, spirit, is not. One thing we can be sure of: we exist. Huh? We exist. I exist right now. And if you're watching this video, well, I guess you also exist in your now. But so much stuff to say. So much stuff to say. Anyway, I'll stop now. Because this connection is too slow and I can't do what I do with it usually. Nice connecting with you people. Those of you who actually connect with me. And yes, I am a Baba, but I'm light years away from what most people assume what a Baba is. And it kind of irks me when people try to, even when they mean well, when they try to shove me into this erroneous conception of what a Baba is. There's truth in the past. I say it again. There's obviously truth now. And there will be truth tomorrow, as well as falsehood. I can't fathom not being brave. I have to be brave. And there have been too many lies. Too many lies. For example, there's a little rumor going around for a while now, for a long time, that Krishna was crucified. That was just a Christian missionary lie. He was not crucified. This hunter mistook his black foot ankle for a black deer behind the bushes. Guess he was hungry. And he shot Krishna. Some say it was by divine providence that this happened. But he wasn't crucified. Anyway, I just wanted to say that. Because Tony Bushby thinks he was crucified like others. That's not true. Let the chips fall where they may, people. Let the chips fall where they may. Om Namah Shivaya. Hare Krishna.